Okay, we're going to look at reaction calculations, and in particular, limiting reactant calculations. So let's consider this reaction. Fe3O4 plus 2 carbons reacts to form 3 irons plus 2 carbon dioxides. So if we start with 55.3 grams of Fe3O4 and react that with 20.1 grams of carbon, we want to determine which reactant is the limiting reactant and determine the amount of each reactant and product at the end of the reaction in grams. So we can represent what we started with in a table. The Fe3O4 is 55.3 grams, the carbon is 20.1 grams, but the iron and the carbon dioxide are 0 grams since the reaction hasn't started yet in that initial run. We'll fill in the rest of this table as we proceed. So we're going to choose a product to calculate in order to determine the limiting reactant, and that'll serve a twofold purpose because that'll also give us the mass of iron at the end of the reaction, which we need to fill in the table. So considering that reaction that we had before, Fe3O4 plus 2 carbons, reactant formed 3 irons and 2 carbon dioxides, we're going to start with 55.3 grams of Fe3O4. You're going to add up the molar mass of Fe3O4, which turns out to be 231.55 grams. And we're going to divide by 231.55 grams of Fe3O4 over 1 mole of Fe3O4. Notice the grams of Fe3O4 cancel, leaving us with moles of Fe3O4. Now, we need to get the moles of iron, this iron oxide, to moles of iron metal. And so we have to multiply by a ratio that will convert from moles of Fe3O4 to moles of Fe. If you look at the reaction, you've got 3 moles of Fe to 1 mole of Fe3O4, where I've included an explicit 1 to make the point of the ratio. So we've got 3 moles of Fe divided by 1 mole of Fe3O4. That will convert us from moles of Fe3O4 to moles of Fe. And then to get grams, we'll need to multiply by the atomic weight of iron, which off the periodic chart, that's 55.85 grams of iron per 1 mole of iron. And then when you run that through your calculator, you will get 40 grams of iron. But we're not done yet. We need to do the same calculation with the carbon reactant. So we're going to start with 20.1 grams of carbon, and we're going to follow the same process that we did before. We're going to divide by the atomic weight of carbon, 12.01 grams per 1 mole. And then we're going to need to convert moles of carbon to moles of iron. There are 2 moles of carbon to 3 moles of iron, as you can see there. 2 moles of carbon goes on the top, 3 moles of iron go on the bottom. And then we need to multiply by the molar mass of the iron, which will give us the amount of iron produced, assuming all the carbon was consumed. And we get 140 grams of iron. Now, looking at that, we see that the iron oxide there produces 40 grams of iron, but from the carbon, I could produce 140 grams of iron, meaning that all of the Fe3O4 is used up first. And so that means our Fe3O4 is the limiting reactant because it produces the least amount of product. And we find that our theoretical yield of the iron is 40 grams. So that is the amount of iron actually produced. So going back to our table, we can fill in some more. We can fill in what we know about the iron and the Fe3O4. We know that we produced 40 grams of the iron, so we gained 40 grams of iron, so we're left with 40 grams of iron at the end of the reaction. Since Fe3O4 is limiting, all of that reactant is consumed, and I have 0 grams of that left at the end. But I still need to calculate the CO2 and the carbon. So next we'll calculate the CO2. Using the same reaction, and now only calculating for what we know to be the limiting reactant, we can calculate the amount of the CO2. So we're going to start with 55.3 grams of Fe3O4. We're going to divide through by the same molar mass that we used before, 231.55 grams per 1 mole. We're going to convert between the 1 mole of Fe3O4 and 2 moles of CO2. And then we're going to multiply by the molar mass of carbon dioxide, which is 44.01 grams. Calculating the answer, we find we get 21.0 grams of CO2 from our limiting reactant. So going back to our table, we find that we get 21 grams of carbon at the end of the reaction, or carbon dioxide. Now for the carbon, we're going to need to calculate that, how much we need of that from the limiting reactant. So using that same reaction, we're going to start with the 55.3 grams of Fe3O4, divide through by the molar mass of the Fe3O4 again. We're going to use our mole ratio between the Fe3O4 and the carbon this time, which is 1 mole of Fe3O4, so 2 moles of carbon. And then lastly, we're going to multiply by 12.01 grams of carbon divided by 1 mole. Calculating that, we find that we would need 5.74 grams of carbon to react up all of the 55.3 grams of the iron oxide. If we go back to our table then, we find that we lose 5.73 grams of carbon, leaving us with 14.4 grams of carbon left at the end of the reaction. So at the end we have none of our limiting reactant Fe3O4. We've got 14.4 grams of the carbon. We got 40 grams of the iron produced, and we've produced 21 grams of CO2. So this has been a tutorial on doing reaction calculations.